Hello and welcome back to PsyOps the Mindgate Conspiracy. And when we last left off, I was trying to make sense of the backstory and this title, considering that we have been called the most formidable agent available to Mindgate, and then they mind wiped us, supposedly. And afterwards, that is the defense of the refinery was all part of the plan, even though the opposing force wasn't aware of our presence. It was just up to random chance and pure luck that we survived and we were taken prisoner. We saw like a good 10 people surviving the assault, right? Something like this. I mean, if that's part of the plan, then it's a terrible plan, frankly. And of course, we also saw the guy running the training facility, essentially. Also not working for this movement, whatever it may be. Yeah, that's very puzzling, to be honest. But then again, we have to escape from this prison first, so why don't we continue today and see what we can accomplish? I'm certainly intrigued here. With our newfound mind powers that are very clunky, the setup.
Nick? You're starting to remember who you really are.
Are you saying I've been brainwashed?
No, memory wiped to hide your psi abilities from the movement probes when you were captured. The shot I gave you should help reawaken your.
Yeah, but how can this be part of the plan? It was completely up to random chance.
Deny it all you want, but how else can you explain?
Well, I'm still going after my men.
It's too late. They're being processed into soldiers for the movement. They're probably being converted as we speak.
My men never.
Okay, so we can add telepathy to the list, I see him. I still cannot get over this control scheme. Why is it Epsilon and, so strange. So goddamn strange, man. Right, the movement's a compound in the silo and locate the rest of our squad. So we do have a mind on our own still, I see him. Okay, landing pad will be our ultimate objective, presumably, I would figure. Cryo storage, huh. Well, I have no idea where that could be. There's also a checkpoint marked for us. Implant ops. Huh. I guess then we have to a wonderful facility and see what we can find, because I have no idea where anything else could be. Who is Leonov? Why do we know this and how? We've been mind wiped, they just said that. How can this be part of the plan? I have no idea, frankly. This is really strange. Okay, so we try to locate our men someplace. I hope that didn't take long. Mind drehen, haha.
Okay, Nick, let's learn about mind drain, also referred to as MD. Mind drain absorbs psionic energy from another person's brain and replenishes your psi energy.
So like a leech, I guess.
Start off with the basics. Eliminate this guard however you'd like, then I'll tell you how to train it.
Okay, from corpses as well, I figure. Oh, didn't work so well, right? We still go for punches though.
Now get close to the body, then press and hold the mind drain button to drain the corpse. Hold the button down. The drain will end automatically. However, if you release early, the draining will stop at that point.
Okay, so it's another way to get some psi juice, I guess, but it's a corpse. How can we drain anything from a corpse? Because the brain's already offline, isn't it?
Draining a dead body only replenishes part of your energy. To replenish all of your energy, you need to drain a live target.
Yeah, you see? See, that's what I figured. And who's really paying these volunteers, quotation mark, because they end up dead? You know, especially if you drain their mind. Whatever. Okay then. That works through Windows, I suppose.
Okay. So let's drain a live target now. You can only drain a person who is unaware of your presence. Sneak up on the enemy from behind until you get close. Then perform the mind drain.
Execute mind drain until they die. Aha. Now, Lee.
That's gotta hurt. Those guys will never get ahead with that job. Sorry. Let's move on.
Yeah, but these are real people, this is not a simulation. Okay, it goes well with his character, I suppose. The first cracks are showing, or were showing 10 years ago.
Now for something a little tougher. I want you to sneak up behind each of these guards and mind train them until they pop, without being detected by either one. Go for it.
Aha, uh-huh. Well, that depends entirely if you can sneak up behind cover or not. Doesn't always work so reliably as we've learned. Like here, for instance, it just doesn't work. Yeah, there we go. Hence also looking out of cover all the time through accident to, lean around corner angle, something like this. It's pretty unfortunate, frankly. It's a third-person shooter, so looking around corners is easier than would be otherwise. Yeah, I think we're fully hidden right now, aren't we? So one guy is manning the console and we have one dude on patrol someplace. I don't think we have access to other powers right now, right? No, of course we don't, only mind drain.
Come on, Nick.
Willy, oh. Yeah, that's what I mentioned. Just about now, it's difficult.
Without being detected by either one. Go for it.
Yeah, because if we crouch walk, we are a little bit more visible, needless to say. So it's mostly a stealth third-person shooter, from what I can get at least. On normal difficulty, we can of course absorb more damage, but still. Yeah, with the crouch walk there, we can just leap from cover to cover unnoticed, unlike the newer DSX games, of course. I have to get the correct angle, it's important, but I can't even see him from back here, so I can't observe his patrol pattern. I'm not quite sure how close we have to be for this mind drain. It wasn't explained really, was it now? Yeah, the controls are a bit wonky in this game, at least in the PC port of the console version. I'm not quite sure how well this will play on Xbox or PS2. No idea. We should be hidden now, they can maybe see our haircut, but that's about it, really. So we have to be really close, I see.
Nice job, Scribe.
Yes, nice job, right? And this volunteer, quotation mark. This is not a simulation, so... well, at least the game doesn't take itself very seriously. That's good. Yeah, it's like melee range almost. Maybe twice the distance, but pretty close regardless. Yeah, that doesn't work for instance. Alright, so it's like 3 times the melee range, I think.
Excellent. Next you replenish your power or die.
Replenish our power or die. Yeah, the head just pops. Again, overripe, well, orange or whatever. Nasty.
For this last test, I'm going to deplete all of your psi energy to start. Then, use mind drain to replenish all of your energy within the time limit. Anything goes, Nick. Do whatever it takes to get all of your psi energy back.
Do whatever it takes, okay. Don't die, that's always a good objective. Not quite sure there's time to sneak around here and observe the patrol patterns. That was noisy. This may also be noisy. Yeah, what's the deal, friend? Okay, could have been better here, presumably. Okay. Of course, they're not invincible when we're doing this. Okay, I'm not quite sure if they will calm down eventually. Yeah, it's two dudes in here because I don't have any time to do some proper reconnaissance. Okay, so this evidently doesn't work because they need to be unawares, which of course they aren't right now. Hopefully we can hide some players for him to calm down. Hopefully that works. Okay, we just do it the hard way. Not smooth,
well,
not clean, certainly.
That was draining. But one thing to remember, Nick. No brain, no drain. Headless bodies have no psi energy. So keep it in mind. Let's get out of here. It's time for Coleman.
He did have a stupid haircut back in the day, I have to say. I think the current style is more, yeah, presentable, certainly. But, of course, you don't have to use it. I think this is just optional for the most part, what I've seen. Anything on CCTV? Well, apparently not. Where the heck are we eben? I have no idea. I guess we are exploring the entire facilities, I suppose. To next map, alright, so we have two options. Door is locked, mhm. War we no key cards are effective in this game already? This one is blinking. Could just use the elevator, whatever works for us. Hopefully it did hurt, yes. I did break this a little bit, as you can see. They threw them right into the... Yes, yes we did. Okay, don't let anything go to waste. Right, probably something like this. Okay, first aid kit and some interesting things here, whatever it could be. Yes, okay, that did unlock the store. Yeah, what is that? No idea, but it's a nice visual effect, especially for 2004. Is it even highlighted anywhere as to what it could be? I have no idea, it's not marked, so I'm not quite sure what this thing is called, if anything. Interesting. I don't think these maps are super useful, by the way. Don't think they're laid out in any particular logical fashion. But yeah, there's plenty of attention to detail in this game when it comes to environmental cues and whatnot. I love that. It's excellent, even. Health and safety, what is that, right? Ideally, we don't want to fall down there. Oh, hello there, friends. Yes, yes, case in point. fantastic. Yeah, there's no cover back here. We have to use our TK powers, so there could be essential sometimes. Also, another lift here to someplace, I'm sure. Okay, goodie. Well, this is a short setback here. I don't think it's too terrible. Come on! That's an obvious work, in case you're wondering. Okay, the Freaker isn't here. If he could stop them a little bit for good measure. Come on! That's a take, man. We need some andere Libo sometimes, okay. I think the first time was smoother, certainly. Okay, goodie. Well, not the problem, there's the first aid kit back here, and we're playing on normal difficulty. Because the game is just too clunky, I suppose, to play on hard. Otherwise, every single misclick would punish us severely. The controls just aren't precise enough, at least I'm opinion. Okay, this time, don't fall down. Can we even call the lift from back here, if you're stuck? Na sure. Ja, holy shit, indeed, Freund, weit. Mann! So, wenn er wieder reliant on these things, then these pickups, and of course there will be other enemy types later on, other environments, I'm sure. Okay, I'm not quite sure what is accomplished, probably nothing, because it was a one-way trip, and apparently we, yeah, crashed someone with that crate. Yeah, isn't that lovely? I'm not quite sure if you can leech away some health eventually, I would assume so. That's not a given, of course. Yeah, alrighty then. Well, good riddance I'd say, but certainly more practice is necessary. Yeah, I wanted them to cover, but so unreliable, hence the enemy seeing me around corners by accident. Okay. There must be some of these cells or... Oh. Wow, it was an obvious trap, I just recognized too late. Yeah, well, that doesn't work so well, evidently. Yeah, but, well, fantastic. There we have it. I love this when the game sets some traps for you. Oh, wow, this one of those guys with the hypo spray. I guess it couldn't be a terrible idea. So apparently I have not learned from my mistakes. Oh, too funny, but we need to come in here anyhow, I see. Oh, isn't that delightful? Yeah, wow, okay, this guy needs to be dealt as well. Come on, get this crate over here. What does it take, man? Freaking just to andere Leibe in this game sometimes. I'm sorry. Come on, get this crate over here. So hard to throw this in any sensible direction. Oh, and throw this fucking thing already in here. What does it take, man? There we have it, finally. Alright, goodie. And of course, even more friends immediately. Okay, oh, once again. This game certainly doesn't turn out to be super easy, especially if you are quote unprepared. But coming here was necessary because we had to have that keycard, of course. Okay, so we're going through these medkits at a rapid pace. Oh, that's delightful. I mean, yeah, that's what I figured would happen. Okay, this guy is toast because he is, took a sniff from this stuff here. Okay, once the valves are open, we can now disable this from the inside, I see. So, well, we know what happens inside here, then presumably. Most likely, right? Is there anything of interest in here? There's a health kit. Of course, we're spending more health than we would be getting from back here. But what we can do is to do this here. Well, sometimes you can. There we have it. Okay, does work. Anything else in here? Thankfully not. Oh, that was certainly both funny as well as embarrassing. Then again, we're still learning the game. It certainly looks pretty high-tech. I'm not sure what this universe is all about, but since we have unrestricted psi abilities, everything goes. Oh, it's actually open. Yeah, for the movement, now the door is closing. Okay, I suppose we can't lay a trap for them right now. Is it even the way to go? I suppose there could be another option, but I don't think there is because we specifically opened the door, didn't we? Probably pretty linear. Yeah, that works over last time, but it's too dangerous to move around, I think. So we can lift him out of cover and then throw him around the director, because, well, it's the Havoc physics engine. I think he's down now, right? Probably. No, not quite. Brazilian fellow. But he can only absorb so much damage, of course. Shotgun, huh? Are we going to try the shotgun in here? Surely we can try that. Camera is also slightly wonky. I do see that health kit over here, of course. And there's a button highlighted someplace, or at least the HUD icon. Not sure what or who we are looking for, but already. Must be these people prepared for processing. To be turned into these mindless goons. Let the game for sure drin.
Sanders! You're not dead. Let's go. I'm getting you out of here.
So it's like a Borg drone only with mind powers. Or through mind powers.
Sarah, I found Sanders and he attacked me like some kind of zombie.
They're meat puppets, reprogrammed with an implant to fight for the movement.
This has to stop. I'm putting this base out of commission.
Get to the mainframe room. I need blueprints on this place, and we need more information on the general's plans.
But shutting this place down, it seems like a sound strategy. We can't allow this to continue. But then probably an alert panel, so we ought not to press it, I think. I'm sorry, friend, that we were unable to help. That's what I say. Yeah, if you're wondering about me jumping next to objects, it's because the jumping and the action button is bound to the same key in this game. So if the interaction doesn't work 100%, you have some interesting yeah, parkouring. Okay, the boss is something glowing red there, which means of course it's Evo. Like this guy. Cryo storage, I don't like the sound of that. Okay, implant ops, it was where our guy just perished, I think. There's also something in this room. And cryo storage seems to be a pretty large area. So plenty of firefights occurring, I would presume, once we get to that point. Not sure, can we smash this through the window? Maybe we can. No is the answer. That's unfortunate, doesn't look like a very sturdy window to me. Yeah, see, they see us, because the enemy is super observant sometimes. Can turn this into a shotgun, I guess. There we have it. It's very effective. Wow, a blown out across the room, the type of situation. This guy, of course, lost his temper and also his head in the meantime. Okay, it's also one of those mangler types in here. Yeah, there we have it. I think a small force only knocks him over. Although we also pumped him full of bullets already. I guess that's how we can attract some guards. Yeah, there I have it. Yeah, holy shit, right? There we have it. I think you deserve to die anyhow, because you just the mind is thrown, aren't you? How many fucking dudes are in here? Probably plenty. Yeah, there we go. Good night, Seed Prince. Yeah, reload is fully automatic in this game. And we only have 5 bullets for the shotgun, or shells even. Okay, that's how we can clear out an area, I guess. Yeah. Right. Okay, that's a funny game. Pretty funny. And apparently we also lose all the ammo when we swap weapons. That's a good thing to notice. Door is locked, huh? Okay, so evidently Nick is not a stealthiest character around. Okay, of course, corpses don't give us the energy we need. I'm not quite sure it works on these scientist types. But considering what they're doing back here, I wouldn't feel any remorse whatsoever. I think he pressed the alert panel, right? Didn't he? Should have used a TK here, presumably. Yeah, there we go, we can turn it off, of course. Yeah, the cyber spray, which cannot go in our inventory. So I suppose since we took out the guards already, there is no reinforcements right now. And this does work on the scientist types. Interesting. Something to remember. Very nice. I'm still getting a hang of the game, but I'm getting better at hooping, yes. Alright, let's just see if we can smash this particular window open. Carefully set it down and we throw it, please. Because it's a propane tank, it's super explosive apparently. Oh, that was off target, but I didn't smash the window anyhow. I suppose they are indestructible. Don't punch the burning barrel there, sir. No, I don't think that works. We already tried this with this a crate, which is made of metal. So video finger would be a little bit more sturdy here. I mean, just hit the glass, yes? With quite a bit of force, but evidently it's not breaking. So I don't think it works. Oh, must be shatterproof glass then, I guess. Do they still have some personality after this conversion process? Maybe. Can we not press the button by taking cover? Well, apparently not. I never unstep from cover when I want to, because it doesn't use the same button. We have to walk away from the fucking wall. That's really annoying. I tell me we should put these people in the furnace. Idea, you want something of the action, then we go. Jesus Christ, man. I'm not sure we have grenades in this game. Hey, I'm not done with you yet. There we have it. Hey! What in the heck, man? No! Okay, I've had enough of you here. Both of you, actually. Hey, why, how are you still fucking alive? I put you in a fucking furnace if I have to. I put you in a goddamn fucking furnace, man. Right? How are you stuck in a table? They're completely helpless, which is something I like to see here because these people deserve to die, frankly. Maybe not a bit. Oh, there we have it. Do you still have something to give? I should hope not. There we go. See, fine, it can be done. It's a stupid alert panel. Okay, we need to, of course, be a little bit more observant here when it comes to our surroundings because they're taking way too much damage. But it's still a very funny game, to be honest. The good thing of playing on normal, not on impossible, anything like this, right? Alright, let's just see what the Mangalas were working on here. Probably some surgery. This room looks pretty nasty and dirty to begin with. Maybe it's just the autopsy stuff. Could be. I suppose since we can now replenish energy from the enemies, it doesn't make as much difference any longer. Okay, implant device. That was the thing we saw there. What? There we have it. So, Dreyfo, sure, we can try it out. Assuming, of course, these people drop some ammo here along the way. And we made a little bit of a mess of this place, evidently. We have it. Yeah, these crates, I think, a weight makes the difference because we have a way easier time throwing bodies around with some precision. These crates, on the other hand, not so much. Okay, so find all of them. Door seems to be locked still, I think, right? Something like that. Man, open the door, Nick. Cannot be so hard. Thank you very much. And it's still locked, right? No, it's not locked. Huh. Implant device used, really? That's strange. Okay, that was another door that was also locked, so maybe it now opens for us. Who knows? Yeah, plenty of boom booms in here. Maybe if we know that the enemy is coming, we can also set up some traps for them. That could be funny. Yeah, implant device. At least we don't put it around our neck here, because we don't have a death wish. Yeah, if only there was my ammo for the shotgun, which of course there isn't, unfortunately so. But otherwise, it seems to be done with this area. Almost. That's a pretty funny ability. The entire game is really funny. I like that. Some corpses apparently do despawn. That's our second shotgun, but I think for now we stick to the assault rifle. Okay, that's the chambers we were looking at. Cryopods, whatever. That's another propaganda poster for the movement. This could be our ultimate objective. Looks like a boss arena or something like this. Probably. Also another passageway for here somewhere. Yeah, that's retraced the entire step, doesn't it? I think it does. Oh, what are they storing in these ice buckets? Well, who are they storing in here? Nothing, I see. At least for now. But there is an entrance back there somewhere. I don't like the unsettling music, though. This is not ominous at all. Of course it isn't. The other window is probably also shatterproof, otherwise I might try to use the explosive stuff around here. I build ourselves a bit of a bridge with these barrels. I don't think that's going to happen. Are there some objects, of course, in the room for this reason? Peekaboo. Anyone home? I suppose we need to get up here in some capacity. That's the main frame, which of course is one of our objectives, but not easily accessible, I would presume. Okay, I don't see any enemies, so maybe we see if it's actually bullet or shatterproof. This is probably the lift we need to access, but there's no obvious button. And that's what I thought, so even with objects I don't think it can be destroyed. Also something underneath here somewhere. I don't see any vents we could utilize either, so I think it's currently the only way to progress.
Sarah, I'm at the mainframe room. The door is locked.
I should have known. This is a high security area. Probably the only one with the password is Jove Leonov.
Leonov?
He runs the Meat Puppet program. He's a
Meat Puppet
Psi agent and master of mind control. The password is in his office. Find a way to get it, but be careful. His powers are dangerous.
Okay, unfortunately, the audio mixing is all off in this game, so I have no idea what you just said. Okay, probably from his office, so this will be our first boss fight, considering how things are going right now, I would presume. Okay, I don't want to stand here ideally, because we're standing in the open, but I want to take a look at the map, of course. Let's just see how we can do this. Warhead storage. Is it upstairs, the area we were unable to access, by chance? Oh, first, it does say it's one of our objectives. This map isn't super easy to read, I think. It's a bit, it doesn't take elevation changes into consideration, right? I don't think it does. Well, it says approximate location. I did move, but the icon didn't change. Okay, we moved through the door at the very bottom. Then we came out in the middle section, I guess. Mainframe room, that's the door that is locked, I would figure. And apparently the office is beyond that door. And then we're using some stairs here someplace to get to the warhead storage and blow the entire facility, I guess. Alright, well, first things first, I try to extract these blueprints. Alright, it claims to be his office, it's also locked, and there's the guy himself here. Yeah, I think it was the guy we saw in training, and he has a conversation with the head honcho. So I don't think we can just walk into here, of course. And of course everyone needs their globe here in this evil organization. I mean, they will be aware of our escape, right? Wouldn't you think? But this apparently is the only way to proceed, I think, right? Yeah, all these cutscenes. That was a mid-2000 game.
Your production quotas leave a lot to be desired, Leonov.
The reprogramming process has taken time to perfect.
Tell that to the General.
The General is quite aware of our setbacks, Barrett. But the operation is now ready to go forward.
We're leaving for the Black Sea today. He expects his quotas to be met.
I understand.
But I don't like it. Can he sense our presence? I think he can. Because he is, well, of course, PsyOps himself. We should probably look if someone is home, right, still. Otherwise it will be a nasty surprise here. Door is locked, of course. Well, how can we open this? Because it's too sturdy to be blown apart with some propane tanks. Yeah, I think he sensed our presence somehow. I think he did. Okay, obviously we have an implant, we have some key cards, but none of them are usable on the store, of course. Yeah, we need to get inside there. I can't even see the back door from back here, even though well, we saw that with our ability, but it's not indicated on the map. But here's the keycard supposedly for the mainframe room because it's a high security area. But how are we getting in here and how are we getting on top there? Because apparently, the mainframe room also provides access to the silo and warhead storage. And it also loops around to the cryo area because he did see that. But I really thought we did venture into every single room. So, well, these games sometimes do leave you guessing, I would think. I don't think that would work. The door is just too sturdy for that. So there needs to be another way around here.
Who's here?
Leave me alone!
Thank you.
you, man.
Ah, so much better. By the way, the game crashed, so we have to replay from our previous hard save, because our checkpoints aren't saved automatically for whatever stupid reason. Oh, hello there. Hierbei ist more practice, I suppose, which is always decent, I think. Yeah, I'm not getting away this time around, pal. I think there was another friend in here somewhere. Probably. Okay, practice makes perfect as the saying goes. I hasn't taken cover, certainly. Okay, let's just drain some juice here. But this thing I do want. What do you mean I cannot care? Oh, whatever. Okay. Okay, I think these are not the same type, are they though? Of course they aren't. Okay, whatever. And of course you have to stand right in the middle of the door to use it. Awkwardly. There we have it. Yeah, there I was. So we're back in this area. There's nothing going on back here, I suppose. And the game has checkpoints, but they don't autosave.
Sarah?
Yeah, I think a brute force is not the solution, because we only have one additional power, that is to walk through doors, essentially. So that's what we're gonna do. Or trying to, for that matter. Because where else would the keycard be? Since this door is indestructible, we cannot blast it open. We already saw that, didn't we? Okay, then we try that. I guess we could sit in cover here. What is this anyhow? Reminds me of Dark Athena, right? From Riddick. These meat puppets, I think they're called them. The same idea, maybe? Presumably. Also this conversion process. Well, isn't that delightful? Well, let's just see if it's actually what we need to be doing, because this door doesn't open for us. There's no key anywhere. We already saw the tooltip. If I were an evil overlord, where would I keep my pass card? Not sure. I mean, there are only so many options. Is it of importance later on? Presumably it would be. Oh, maybe this one? It's very blurry, but we do see the keycard. So 3448, okay. Apparently I have to keep a piece of paper next to my keyboard as in Deus Ex. 3448, okay. 3448. Well, then we see what we can do. Oh, hello there. So apparently we've been expected since it guided since our presence. Okay, yeah, alrighty then. So good to know, we have some friends waiting for us. It's all of them. No, this guy is still around. Are we auto-aiming when we're doing this? I hope so. Apparently it was insufficient damage. Okay, goodie. Well, lovely. What the welcoming committee. Yeah, 3448 I think it was, wasn't it? 3448. Of course I have to stand in the middle of the door to access the keycard, I would suppose. Right, problem. Okay. 3448. Yeah, and of course immediately there's someone right around the corner. That's what I figured. Okay. I'm not sure how we can deal with them pretty easily. They seem to be entrenched. Ha ha ha, it never gets old. The physics engine in this game. And we have an unlimited supply of these here, at least for the time being. I do think that's going to change eventually. Yeah, yeah, pal. Hello there. And this wall angle is so goddamn unreliable. Not sure how much room there is back there for throwing people. At least, yeah, so it hurts. Your body doesn't hurt enough. Hello? Okay, we can also do this around the corner. It's bound to hurt. Ah, this is fantastic. Okay, well, since we had to replay this entire section, why don't we full on a save? Although the last checkpoint will be, of course, the dead one, right? Presumably, not after all this conversation stuff. Don't need it, right? We can hit our south of that door, interesting enough. Alright, so we have a free item per type of situation in this game. I would figure. So, what? I'm still not quite sure if we can find anything in these lockers. Otherwise, why can we kick them open? No idea. Apparently, there's nothing in here after all. Who doesn't love some sludge? Not a med kit. I wouldn't trust this one because it's floating in dirty water. I'm not quite sure that qualifies as a secret necessarily. Or hidden area? Probably not. It's too easy to find.
Did you find anything?
Yeah, a map of the movement's compounds and blueprints of this place.
Great, send me the data. Meet me in the warhead storage room off of the main silo.
Where?
According to these plans, there's an air duct that leads to the silo shaft from the mainframe room. Look around, you're right there.
If only I could understand you because you are too quiet, but something about an air shaft, this thing possibly. Okay, well, we know what to do, I'm thinking. Only it wasn't so finicky, right? Because movement controls of Nick and movement controls of the crater are independent things, but right now, that's confusing. And these are too heavy to be pushed around, I think, indeed they are. Okay, it just breaks apart, I guess. But we need more leverage here, hopefully there's another crater around. Hopefully they stay in the correct position, because that's not a given, as you can see. Otherwise, you cannot grab up here. Nick, come on, try to concentrate. And they have to be level? No, we can make it happen regardless. Well, that's nice. Okay, an air duct is set. Well, I don't have a flashlight, so I'm not quite sure. What happens if you accidentally throw that crate out of here? I suppose you have to restart from the last checkpoint. Okay, press the emergency override button for that fan, I guess. But the game did save, hopefully, because I don't want to replay this section yet again, as fun as it was. Do we have this indicated anywhere for that matter? Okay, this is the air vent passage. Telling us about some interesting environmental chaos, don't they? Or trying to, but it's a bit hard to navigate. I still don't think the map is super useful. Of course, if you see us, because there's no cover back here. Well, why not, Nick? That's a line of sight on us. He will be pretty soon. But is suppressed, technically speaking? What? How? What? How? I mean, the way I took is pretty obvious, but the game is just spawning enemies behind us now. Okay, so we have to be an outpost, then I presume. Never mind all these traps here, incidentally. Okay, that's nasty. That sounds right naughty of your game. At least it gives us some side juice, I guess. But yeah, so they spawned in this room, didn't they? Probably. Really now? Because the field of vision is also super narrow, so it's hard to react to these things in time. I mean, that's dangerous, certainly. If anyone wasn't here, there would be a slice to ribbons now, of course. We don't want the same, yeah, fate here, essentially. Interestingly enough, the bodies are still here. We would think they would be sucked into this vortex. Apparently not. Well, Nick isn't exactly the stealthiest character around, as we already know. Is it still running? It's hard to say, because of the audio mixing. Oh. There we have it. Yeah. Well, that solves three problems for us. I'm not complaining. This game doesn't take itself very seriously. That's fantastic. Okay, I sure hope it's all the dudes around here. Yeah, bloody fan blades. Fantastic, right? Gnarly. Yeah, this game is not for children. Yeah, I'm not going back there. Forget about this. It's so dangerous. Someone else can press the button. Certainly. Yeah, also the bodies have weight and everything, so snugging to cover is even more difficult than otherwise. But I think it's not the only party in here, I would presume. I only wish there would be an automatic pickup on these corpses. Of course, otherwise getting a bit repetitive, wouldn't you think? Yeah, I just cannot snap to cover because these bodies are in the way. That's the problem right now. But it's certainly having a bit of a power trip at this point in time. I would like to try the shotgun, but the problem is ammo usually. Looks like a Spaz 12 with the stock folded to make it even more unwieldy. That is impractical. Aber just jumping in here, but I don't think it's the best idea. But we're looking for warhead storage now, aren't we? I just picked up the shotgun. Warhead storage, what are we storing in here? That's the lady waiting, we'll see some boom booms. What door may open, it may not open, I'm not sure, and this is the silo still. Alright. Yeah. I jump and I don't want to because it's bound to the same button as action.
Not quite. These warheads don't have any nuclear material left, but they still have plenty of the conventional explosives. I've salvaged them for the materials we need for you to blow this base.
Me?
You train for this kind of op at Mindgate.
Mindgate?
The secret PsyOps arm of the US military. They sign our paychecks. Wow. Don't you remember anything? The memory wipe allowed you to be captured. Your true memories were supposed to return once you were past the movement's mind probes. I'm sorry, Nick. Something's gone wrong, but we have to move on. According to the blueprints, this base has a major structural fault. I've marked three key locations. Placing the explosives there will take the whole place down. Mindgate is counting on us.
Are they though? That seems to be pretty fishy from what we have seen. Who's really running the show? Okay, Implant Ops is where we came from, I believe. Just in the most convoluted way possible. Okay, well, we shouldn't be seen together, of course. So what's it, all that lovely stuff in here? Pistol ammo? Okay, but it's the wrong type of ammo, though. That's the problem. Yeah, pistol ammo is not dropped by the enemies, so that's nice, but still. I suppose we can come back here if we need more juice or pistol ammo for that matter, or we can try to be stealthy. Although Nick isn't very stealthy, evidently. So, how do we go back to a PsyOps then for that vent, which probably close behind us? Oh, never mind. They tell us there are some people around, but no guardrails. Oh, really? What? What? Yeah, the eye is super observant, and now, of course, it's off limits. You can't go back there. Oh, fantastic. So, where was this guy blasting from? From up here, huh? Did he fall to his doom? I'm not quite sure because I didn't get to see. Yeah. Right on the platform, unfortunately so. So much for being stealthy, I guess. And snap to cover already, what does it take, man? It's so unreliable. Yeah, holy shit, because there's a little gap here, right? Come on. Does it take, man? Just drop him off there. There we have it. Slam it in the floor and then down the bottomless pit. Yeah, that's what I like to see. Yeah, this game certainly isn't easy, but now we need this rejuvenator thingy. Also, before the door still opens for us, which is chill. Otherwise, I'm going to blow it open. Okay, are they specific? Apparently, they are. They look the same to me, though. Okay, whatever you want to do, their game. I think it's fine in my book. Also, some pistol ammo because I used some bullets, didn't I? But regardless, let's just see what we can accomplish. Of course, the lack of handrails goes both ways. Yeah, that was the problem, why? Because a 3D environment. 3D environment. Remind myself, please. I think we stick to the sides, why it's probably safer. What is that? I have no idea. Yeah, somebody's on the ground. I wonder who was responsible for that. Do I feel like jumping this? Probably not. But, how did the enemies come over here? Because they came from the left, didn't they? And snap to cover, you idiot. Thank you very much. Of course, I deprive myself of some useful materials, you know, like, side juice, if I do this. Yeah, I can also remove the cover, it also works sometimes, but I think this is more effective, all things considered. If only I didn't pick up that stupid shotgun. Okay, if they're down, then I can siphon away some juice from them, maybe. Okay, cross this quickly. Don't think we can sprint, though. No, I don't think we can sprint. Idee? What? What? But if you want to spawn an enemy, stop making that obvious, their game. There was no one in this corner, there was no one around here, yet there were people suddenly blasting me from close range. Like, seriously. That's not very nice of you, I have to say. That's not very nice at all. Okay, I'm not going to see what that did, but the button was interactable, yes. Yeah, this is the implant lab situation, I believe. Okay, anyone else waiting for me? That's a technician, I think. Yeah, lab technician or someone like this. I would suppose we have to come through this way then to plant that bomb. That didn't work so well, right? Yeah, right in your ugly face, mate. That's what you deserve. Yeah, we can pick it up from very far. That's also a problem. Okay, I don't feel there's any point of going up here again. There was nothing we left behind. Right, game. I just know what happens, right? If you don't do this. So let's just see. Don't go in here. We saw a better solution to this problem. I'm not concerned why we triggered the gas trap when people were already working inside. This game is full of traps though. That's pretty nasty. Okay, I think the problem is hiding like this here behind crates makes us too visible because they can see our hair. We have to snap to cover, which of course is very unreliable in this game, unfortunately so. As is unsnapping for that matter. So I wasn't lying about the fact that PsyOps is of course the first generation cover shooter. It's very clunky. Very clunky indeed. But I think we can adapt, yes. Okay, so far seems pretty clear, but I wouldn't count on this. I'm not going to have time stops when we are utilizing this ability. Sort of pop that makes you go pop, I guess. Like this here. Lovely. And you also have a hypo spray by chance for me, but apparently not. How rude of you, sir. Yeah, it's at the end of this corridor, if I'm not misremembering. Of course, a cover versus no cover doesn't make a difference back here, but otherwise it seems to do. Of course, the one dude is in here once more. Another dude. Of course, doesn't mean anything since the game also spawns enemies behind us by looks of it. And of course, there is Joseph working again. They can see us if we don't take cover. And they cannot interact with him through the window, I would suppose. Right? I don't can. That's good. Yeah, break his bones. Break his goddamn fucking spine, because that's what he deserves. I think he's dead. No. That's what I get. Yeah, that hurts, right? Especially if you remove your cover, that shoot you a little bit. I know the crate is too heavy to make this reliable. Okay, I think it was an accident to headshot by the sounds of it, that's good. So, new friends to play with. Thankfully not right now. Well, was spoke too soon. Something just shot me, which fine too. What was that? Okay, it's a weird physics interaction because, well, it's a Havoc game, essentially, from 2004. It's bound to be janky. But I want that sweet side juice, of course. Yeah, ammo is becoming more scarce because they're using different types of firearms, I guess. Oh, this is so unreliable. Snap to this wall already. I think he was mobile, wasn't he? I think he was. And apparently this area is a structural weakness. Yeah, the game is pretty generous when it comes to the hit detection, which is nice of it. Okay, should probably use one of those, shouldn't we? Didn't mean to use two, but there we have it. Okay, so where are we planting this bomb? Well, it should tell us, of course, shouldn't it? Implant Ops, isn't it where we are right now? I think it's Implant Ops. Yes, we are the faucet of the room, so it should be implant option to be. Maybe not. Oh, okay, adventure too far. That's already not where we need to be going. Okay, goodie. So was the other room because we did see a large piece of machinery in there. Okay, goodie, but it was certainly interesting knocking all these people once again. Of course, people will be angry once we plant some bombs, I would presume. But why would we care? Right, buddy? Well, I do hope it's marked for us. So even Microbrain can figure it out. And indeed, it is marked. Don't make it too obvious. Yeah, we know where the mainframe room is, of course. So this area was not optional anyhow. That's good to know. Hopefully, there's a sensible timer on these bombs. Is the door still open? Because I forgot the code. I think it was 3448, wasn't it? I wonder if it changes between gaming sessions. No idea. Can we snap the cover already, you idiot? Look at how unreliable it is. Look at how unreliable it is. No wonder it doesn't work for me, especially when I need it the most. I smell some shenanigans in here. So let's just try to cross that room quickly. Yeah, these two open. I'm still expecting people to respawn here in the back someplace. Okay, the door is still unlocked, which is excellent. Maybe we can also take another look in here, but I don't think it's going to open. No, but why not, man? Just look in here. Maybe the guy is working back on his computer. Yeah, 3448, but the door is unlocked still, which is nice. It's a fancy fireplace. Probably connects to the same gas furnace as the the other one, right? Probably. Knock knock, anyone home? Well, of course there's someone home. And the technician. And some boom booms on the roof there someplace. Yeah, so unreliable. Does the door at least stay open? Want to, of course, drain his juice. Not that type of juice, of course. You naughty boys. This is probably good practice. As you can see, I'm trying to look around the corner, but the game just doesn't allow me. And there we go. It's certainly not a game for children. I should just leave the technician in here, I think. Yeah. Oh, and these games with these old physics engines, you can't account for this stuff anyhow. Vinny, how are you still alive? Not for much longer, if I have anything to say about this. Certainly pretty resilient in your lab coat there, sir. I will have to give you that. What? You're not armored, I do? What in the actual heck, mate? Can I have some of that, please? Are you just on stims? Could also be. No idea, man. Okay, at least you didn't get to press the button. And my handiwork from last time is still here. Okay, cryo storage, which was just around the corner. I did see that here. Apparently we're out of that. And then we make our grand escape, I guess. Somehow. Do we have some room for the other medkit by chance? I just fed out. No. Apparently not. Na Gott, so was kommt ich so ein Portenbord Cryo Storage? Wer wird wie eben plant? Oh, der reit hier. That's a structure weakness, apparently. Hm, na, weidi. I'm expecting a boss fight in here. Where do we even keep these things? Especially three of them.
Well, what a resourceful little rat that's wandered into my maze. I'll enjoy bending your mind to my will. I'm not too fond of getting my hands dirty. Instead, I take over the minds of others. They do everything I say, like good little puppets. They even see for me.
Yes, you don't need eyes, but we are going. Please keep these goggles on, sir. It's unsettling. New objectives, now's not the time, I guess. Okay, so these are suicide bombers, I guess. Apparently they are. Okay, hello there. Right, a pretty convenient crate, I have to say. Oh, fantastic. So apparently your mind powers can make people explosive.
Where are your powers now?
Yeah, that's the problem, right? We have so much juice. Yes, thank you. Yes, okay, I think we need to destroy these respawners because they will be infinite, I suppose. Okay, 100. I guess I'll use one of these. Yeah, we need to throw these boom-booms in here, I think. That's probably the idea. Yeah, I'm out of ammo. Oh, goody. Finest soldiers, yes. Whitey. I don't think we're getting rid of him here easily. So wasn't in the boss fight area, that's what I figured. Of course, yeah. Thank you, sir. Okay, I'm not sure where we are going because I have no control since he's controlling me, of course. Okay, this is getting very exciting here, certainly. Yeah, eat this, huh? I need some goddamn ammo, man. His high abilities are annoying, sir. I can't do anything right now, can't return. Take a Sith Lord. And these crates are terrible for throwing stuff. Need some goddamn ammo. Ammo, please, ammo, 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 ammo. Ah, this is so annoying. Yeah, I'm completely stuck now. Yeah, of course, Psy Powers are the key to this particular mission. But I'm not sure what else I can do about him. Except for the crate. Which doesn't work very well, I will have to say. I don't want to walk towards him, thank you very much. Apparently, I have no choice then. Yeah, Meadow Crate is your ultimate nemesis, I see. nudging him ever so slightly.
I have your mind.
It seems painful, yes? Oh yeah, supervillains losing track of the important things. Must have too much fun. Well, that can't be good. What type of structural weakness is this, if you can just survive this explosion?
Nick, where are you? Meet me on the landing pad.
I'm on my way.
Hurry, you don't have much time before the other two bombs go off.
Yeah, well, which way to the side door? Oh, not this way apparently, because it was a one-way trip for us. Frankly, I don't remember the way, that's a problem. I should probably look at the map here, why? Because it could offer some interesting and important insights at this point in time. Okay, landing pad apparently is all the way on the top as you would think, but they only give us 3 minutes and it's not the most okay, implant ops. Warhead storage. I suppose we may not be reaching our objectives in our first attempt. Probably not, because they only give us 3 minutes and the path is confusing. There probably also will be some opposition along the way. Yeah, indeed there is. Just ignore them, we have other concerns. Are we going the correct way? Not into the obvious gas chamber, please. Okay, they have up armored these people apparently. That's nice for them. Okay, open that fucking door, please. What has happened there? What? That's a bit too much for me. I think I fell down right now. Okay, goody. So I need to probably get some help here before we perish and find some cover maybe. 3 minutes for this here. Okay, where they even shooting from? I have no idea. Yeah, not this way, evidently. And for fuck's sake, leave me alone, you idiot. Yeah, we have it. Okay, over this rickety position here, I suppose. Right into more people. No. Just the type I see. Door is locked, of course it will be locked. So where the heck are we fucking going? The landing pad is all the way on the top. Is the elevator? I have no idea. Goody, okay, fantastic. So we're perishing because we cannot find our way, I would suppose. That's the problem here. Don't have time for you, buddy. Good night, Seed Prince. You're getting on my nerves, have other problems right now, you idiot. Yeah, that's probably a good idea. So before we head out of here, take a medkit and some side juice. Alright, that's a good idea. Hello there, friend. They're getting knocked on my asses again. Man, stop this fucking bullshit. Yeah, the button is right here, I think. Oh, what the fuck, man? Man, stop that shit, you idiots. Okay, the elevator didn't reach all the way to the top, so we're supposed to get off here because I don't think so. So once again, it's good that this is all by accident because it's not on the landing pad. Oh, I really hate a fucking obtrusive mission design, I really do. Okay, so we need to stay on the elevator, I think. So once again, we do our trick for the 10th time or so. Ammo at the same time, of course, as you would think. Oh, the light form. Who knew it would be so hard to escape this facility because there is time pressure involved. Maybe there's more ammo. Hopefully. Yeah, stay in that fucking elevator, I would figure. Hello there, TK. Thank you very much. Even the best effects I get would eventually, wouldn't you think? Get in already. Fantastic. Thank you. Oh, so annoying. All the screen checking isn't helping at the same time, wouldn't you think? There we go, press the stupid button, this time stay on the elevator. Or try to. Thanks, pal. Okay, also take some sweet, sweet health juice. Stay on the elevator, don't go off this time around. Okay, and where's our exit? Oh, this thing is not moving very speedily. But I can finally see the landing pad. Whatever, you can do whatever you please, I don't care. I don't care right now with other concerns. There we go. Okay, you have a different weapon, unfortunately so. Open this door, please, open this fucking door. Jesus Christ, man. And all of this in 3 minutes, of course. There's still some idiot back here. Are we going the correct way? I have no idea. How did it survive that anyhow? So, less than 1 minute. You're getting annoying, sir. Okay, this seems to be the landing pad, I think. Well, thankfully. Hopefully it's a friendly VTOL.
Nick Squire. I should have killed you when I first saw you. The best agent I ever trained returns to me as my enemy.
Train me.
So it is the same general I see. Well, hopefully we have a plan B here. That would be why, with an old school helicopter. Oh, there we have it. That was certainly a very interesting mission here, much harder than anticipated. So we destroyed 80 items. I'm not quite sure which runs will be combined here because I had to restart from my previous save game, of course. Only 34. Okay, of course there was some time for accurate headshots this time around. I did inflict plenty of property damage. Yeah, plenty of things went wrong here, of course. Interesting. Very interesting, but I think it's all we can do for this episode. So next time around, we try to see where things will be taking us from here. But otherwise, I thank you for watching as usual, and hope to see you next time.